Hey YouTube, what is going on? This is iTalk.
And here we go.
Here, and in today's video, we have a brand new video. If you're new to my channel, you might not know that at the end of every single season, I talk about every single skin that came out during the season. I've done this for 5, I've done it for 6, 7, 8, 9, X, or 10. And yes, we are going to do it with this season, Chapter 2, Season 1. Every skin and back bling that came out during this time. I'm going to tell you right now while I'm recording this audio, I am so nervous that this is going to be like a 2-hour video. I really hope it doesn't turn into that, but it could very well be. This is the longest season we've ever had by far. We've had so many cosmetics come out during this time, and without beating around the bush, let's just get started. I'm also gonna just note here, I'm going to try to keep everything in order of release. I know for a fact that this is not going to happen because there was just too many skins and I couldn't get them all perfectly in order, but I'm going to try my absolute hardest. So we're gonna start off with the Battle Pass skins. First off, we had was the Journey versus Hazard, and I'm just gonna quickly say right here, while we're on the topic of the first skin here, I was never a fan of the names. I really dislike how long the names were for like most of the Battle Pass skins. I wish it was just called Journey and then the edit style was just called Hazard style for the Journey skin. I'm not really a huge fan of this whole versus in the names, but this skin right here is actually really nice. I like the edit style a little bit. I'm not the biggest fan of it. Almost the hood doesn't even feel that intimidating, even though I feel like that's what they were going for, was like an intimidating hood, but they really kind of didn't do that for me. I don't know. This one didn't really feel too good in the sense of like an alternate ego, because that's what the theme of the season was alternate egos. It didn't really do it for me with this skin. It just felt too tame, and I still enjoy the skin. I still think it's a really good one. I think it was going for intimidation, but it just did not come off that way with that edit style. She also came with the Backbling Base Camp bag, and this is also going to be something I'm going to mention here. I thought that the cosmetics this season were excellent. However, a lot of the backblings felt really lazy. Like, a lot of the backblings felt like boring backpacks, and you'll see what I mean when we get on later on in this video, how similar a lot of these backblings are, and I just was not a fan of it. This backbling was actually pretty decent. Everything in this battle pass, I'm pretty sure, has an edit style to them, and I thought they did the edit styles very well, and I thought the regular ones were good as well. This battle pass overall was very solid. I don't think it was bad at all, but I know a lot of people didn't really like it, but I personally did enjoy it. And then the next skin we have here was the Turk versus Riptide. And actually, Turk actually kind of looks like me in a little bit. Like, he's got the same beard and the same hair as me. I like wearing beanies, so that also works as well. Riptide looks like something out of Metal Gear Solid to me. And this definitely feels like an alter ego edit style. It looks a lot more intimidating. It looks a lot more aggressive. I love the way these skins look. They look very, very good in my opinion. The colors are very subtle. This also comes with the Backbling Tackle Box, which is also a fairly decent back bling. Again, it's another kind of backpacky kind of feel to it, but I still think that this skin was done very well. The next skin we have here was Ripley versus Sludge. Ripley was a very comedic character, and then the Sludge edit style, the red one, was very aggressive. That one felt really like almost evil in a way. I enjoy that. That actually looked very intimidating. Again, I think it fit the ego part very well. Again, it seems like Journey versus Hazard, the Hazard just did not feel that intimidating to me at all. It was just her with green hair and a hood over her head. That's all it was to me. So I didn't think it was like anything super special, but to me, the Ripley versus Sludge was very, very well executed. He's very, very big. That might turn off players. A lot of people like wearing very skinny outfits, and that pretty much just tells me that Ripley was barely ever used unless you were just a casual player, which there's nothing wrong with that. And they also gave him a purple edit style, which looks very adorable. I kind of figured they were going to give him a purple edit style because of the trailer for this season showed that the water was actually turning purple, even though we never saw that in the actual season. The water was turning purple, and it made sense for Ripley to just be purple. So they gave him a purple edit style for the overtime challenges, and it looks really funny on him, and I think it looks really good. Not much else to say about it. Really creative outfit, though, and we've never seen anything like this before. Next skin we had was Remedy versus Toxin. Now, Remedy is probably the best skin from this battle pass. Remedy versus Toxin is really good. Remedy is just your typical lifeguardy kind of feel skin. Like, we've seen this before in battle pass and item shop skins. We've seen this before, so it's not very original. And then when you get to the Toxin edit style, I think they did a fantastic job on making it look like an alter ego edit style. The mask almost kind of ruins it for me. The mask almost looks really cheap, and that's one thing I've noticed with Battle Pass skins in general, is that the skins almost feel like a fabrication, and they feel like they're really disposable. Like, a lot of the back blings I've seen for Battle Pass skins, especially for Season 10, felt like paper. They felt like plastic. They felt very unoriginal, and they felt just very cheap to wear. Like, I felt like I was just wearing plastic sometimes. And the mask for the Toxin Mask edit style almost gives me that visual a little bit. And if you will unlock the purple edit style for completing some overtime challenges, right here is the best Battle Pass skin, in my opinion. For this season, this is the best Battle Pass skin with this edit style. It is so intimidating. I love the mask. I love the purple. It is without a doubt my favorite Battle Pass skin from this season with this edit style. I love it. Very, very well executed. Great job, Fortnite. It's a really good one. And she also comes with a backbling antidote, which I don't really have anything really to say about it. It's okay. I'm not the biggest fan of it. Again, the purple version looks pretty decent. The toxin one also looks very good. The antidote, like the normal edit style, not doing it for me. Just not a fan of it at all. We've seen it before. Next skin we had here is the 8-Ball versus Scratch. Now, 8-Ball is actually really neat. I love the concept of like a billiard style outfit. And I think he might be kind of like the antagonist for this upcoming season, because if you guys are unaware, if you've been on Twitter at all, you would know that there's a bunch of teasers going around about a gold themed season. There's a lot of hints towards 8-Ball being the main protagonist, but yeah, the gold 8-Ball versus Scratch is a really clean design as well. And it makes me think that, again, he's going to be like the main bad guy for this kind of storyline, which I think is really cool. He's very intimidating, especially with the Scratch edit style. It's very clean, very cool with all the white. And if you progress during the season, I think if you got to level 350, he would be fully corrupted, which was very interesting. I don't think we really had any real idea as to why he was getting corrupted. I don't know if there was like a clear-cut answer to that, but still, I think this skin was done very, very well, very clean, probably my second favorite in the Battle Pass. We also got the ball bling back bling, which looks okay. I didn't run it, if I'm being honest with you. Not really the biggest fan of it. It looks nice, but again, I don't run too many different back blings that are related to the Battle Pass. Again, I just find them kind of cheap. This one wasn't too bad, though. I didn't think this one was the worst I've ever seen. Then we had the skin Cameo versus Chick. Now, the Chick version of this skin is fantastic. I love the way this looks. The Cameo version we'll talk about first here, though. I love how crazy it looks. It almost gives me kind of like a Joan Jett vibe, even though it looks nothing like Joan Jett. It just gives me that feeling of like, hey, I'm just kind of like a rock star kind of chick. And it looks great with six string. Without a doubt, it looks really good. And the Chick edit style is actually really good. Reminds me a lot of Ariana Grande. The glasses give me a Willy Wonka feel. The skin is executed perfectly. I love this edit style as well. The yellow, I'm not the biggest fan of. It doesn't look that great to me, at least. But now that we're seeing all these teasers, it makes me think that this might also have something to do with the storyline revolving around the gold theme that we might be getting for next season. And it looks okay. You took off the glasses and you gave her like this very bright yellow feel. It's okay. It could have been worse. But I do love the Chick edit style as well. This was, again, probably top three for Battle Pass skins. It also came with a backbling called Blade Bag. I have nothing much else to say about it. I never really used it, but I still think it looks very good. The final skin we had for the Battle Pass, not including the secret one, was the Fusion skin. He has three edit styles. He had the Fusion, the Vex, and the Zev edit styles, and these skins look very good. I like how intimidating each one of these edit styles were. This skin did not have a versus edit style, I'm assuming because it's already a bad guy already, so there isn't really an evil version to him. So yeah, I like the edit styles a lot. I remember I got him in like, I think 30 minutes after the season released. I bought the entire Battle Pass, and the edit styles to unlock for him were very, very easy. Everyone else was like, you had to wait a week to get them, so it was a little bit annoying. But with this guy, I was like, yeah, here are the challenges right away. I guess it was a thank you for buying the entire Battle Pass. You just got the edit styles right away, I suppose. You just had to do some simple challenges for him. I like the edit styles a lot. Fusion is very hard to green screen, by the way, for thumbnails. The regular edit style for Fusion is a pain because he has all that fire and smoke coming off of him. The Vex version almost looks like something out of Destiny, which is totally okay. I still think it looks good. And then the Zev version is really cool with like the white and the gold. Looks very well done. Very good tier 100 skin in my opinion. And then the backbling was Fusion Orb. Really didn't like this one. The backbling kind of jutted out a little bit. Just wasn't the biggest fan of it. So I'm going to say that the skin itself though was very well executed. I'm very happy that we did get this. I feel like for this season especially, everyone got the tier 100. If you just played a little bit, the XP this season in the very beginning was very bad, but then they ramped it up to 11 and now it was extremely easy to get. It was one of the easiest seasons. You literally had like 5 months to get this battle pass done, and you had challenges on top of challenges on top of challenges to just get as much XP as you possibly could have. You had the daily punch card, which gave you almost a guaranteed level every single day. There's no question in my mind, if you played the game a decent amount, you should have gotten tier 100 this season. And then the secret skin we had this season was the Serana skin. Again, there is no versus. I'm assuming that means that she is also kind of like a bad guy. And she has the default style, the green, and the gray. She also came with the backbling Ready Ruck, which also came with edit styles if you just did some simple challenges. And this skin was really well executed. Really like this one a lot. It looks very intimidating. Never really ran her too much. I kind of feel bad about it. There's just too many skins that come out for me to like try to use every single one and give a certain amount of time to every single skin. When you become a skin collector, it is very difficult to actually manage time between skins. I've seen a lot of people, I know I'm going off track here, but I've noticed a lot of people saying, you know, why don't you use Power Cord that often? I have too many skins. It's almost impossible for me to give time to other skins and actually give a decent review on them for me to actually tell you what I think about the skins. So Serana to me, I thought was a very well executed skin for a secret skin. It's probably the second best right next to the Singularity. I don't think anything is beating Singularity as a secret skin for a season. Singularity was just so good. So many edit styles, so many different colors. It was basically perfect in my opinion. That one was fantastic. And that was all the battle pass skins. Now it's time to get into the item shop skins and everything else in between, all the packs, all the exclusives, everything. And I'm gonna let you know right now, I'm gonna try to keep this in order, but it's not going to be in perfect order. So the first skin that we got here was the Zero skin, and it comes with a back bling black hole. Now Zero in of itself is the first legendary skin of this season, as well as there was only I think one or two other legendary skins this season, which is pretty crazy. I use the backbling a ton more than the actual skin Zero. Zero to me is just way too flashy. People could see you from a mile away. It's a very unique skin. I totally understand why he's worth legendary. I wouldn't even put him as an epic. But for me to actually use him and enjoy the game while using him, probably not. It's just not for me. The backbling though is an amazing backbling. It doesn't give away your position at all. I think that was done very, very well. And that's what my thoughts are on that. Then the next skin we have here is the Outcast skin, and it comes with the back bling Fresh Catch. And again, I don't like these kind of back blings because they just feel too similar to one another. You'll see what I mean as we go on further on with the video. So Outcast was a really decent outfit. I felt like the normal edit style was okay. Like, I still think the skin almost looks like she's trying to smile, even though for some reason, like, her face just can't smile. She reminds me of someone from Teen Mom. Don't ask me why, but that's what I get from her. She kind of looks like someone from Teen Mom. I can't really explain that, but the alter ego edit style looks fantastic. But I'm going to say the same thing I said about the first skin here on Journey versus Hazard. This is the alter ego edit style. This does not look like an evil fisherwoman to me at all. It doesn't really give me that vibe at all, but I love the colors. I love the hair color. The beanie color is great. The little purple going on around the accents of her body looks really good. Matches perfectly with Six String, and you know me, I love that back bling. It was a very well done skin, and I don't think many people even remember the skin even existing. The back bling, can't say I like it at all, but that is my opinion on the Outcast skin. Next skin we had here was the Snug skin, and it comes with the back bling Broken Heart. Now, fun fact, when you search for Snugs in your locker, the middle of the name gets censored. I don't know why it does that, but regardless, Snugs is the first male cuddle team leader. I'm very positive about that one. I'm pretty sure it's the only male cuddle team leader. Looks really good. The back bling almost felt a little too bulky to me, but the skin itself is very fantastic. Felt like Five Nights at Freddy's. Still kind of feels that way to me, not gonna lie. It's a very well done skin, and it's a rare cuddle team leader, which we don't really see very often. I mean, we saw another rare cuddle team leader in this season, but we'll get to that when we get to that. But yeah, Snugs to me, I think, is very well done. Again, rare for a cuddle team leader is very uncommon to see. No pun intended with the rarities there. It's a very good skin. I actually really like this one. It was a very good Halloween-esque skin. And yeah, I really hope people actually gave this one a chance. I don't think many people did, but I still think this skin is very, very good. Next we have to talk about is Teef, and he comes with a backbling Nosh. Now Teef to me is one of the most creative skins we have in Fortnite in general, not even including Halloween skins. This one is fantastic. I love the feel to this skin. He is like an abomination, a monster created by someone or something. I don't necessarily know, but it looks so... It looks intimidating at first, but then when you kind of like look at the back bling and you kind of just like look at him like he's standing on stilts. It's adorable to me. I don't know why, but I love this skin. It's so good. And I don't think many people again gave this one a chance, but Nosh has seen a lot of popularity in the Piezo community, which is really cool because I always like to see communities kind of gather around a certain thing. And I think that the Nosh back bling is amazing. Goes pretty much with everything. You could just slap that on everything and it would look pretty good. And to me, I think Teef is one of the best Halloween skins we've ever had, period. This pretty much blows Skull and Ghoul Trooper way out of the water as they got a lot better with the skins over time. But Teef, to me, is one of the best that we got. Next skin we had here was Jawbreaker, and she comes with a back bling containment unit. Now, I thought she was kind of like a goth girl, which I still kind of get that way with her, but she's barely pale. What they did with the season is they made a lot of skins that look pale in their preview pictures look very tan. But I think the skin itself is very adorable. I love this skin. It's very good. I should use it more often than I really do. Containment unit is not the greatest. Again, it's a backpack. Kind of tired of seeing these. But in of itself, I think Jawbreaker is a very solid skin. Very one-colored with this one. I still think it looks good, though. You got a little bit of pink accent on like the bullets around her waist. I still think it looks great. And I should really start running this skin more often, as I said already. The next skin we have here is Chaos Agent, and he comes with a backbling ooze chamber, and he also has an edit style to take the mask off. And oh my god, I'm keeping that mask on because it's terrifying. He looks a lot like Slenderman with that face, and the mask itself is very cool. Love the look of it. Very skinny and very mischievous. He's very vital to the part of this storyline, I feel like, because there's loading screens showing that. And he does come out from time to time. He's not just a Halloween skin. Very cool, very well done. Love what they did with the skin. Three fingers as well, by the way, which is very creepy. And again, I should probably run this skin more often. Next we got to talk about is the Final Reckoning bundle, which included three skins, the Willow skin, the Katrina skin, and the Black Light. And we're just going to go in that order. So Willow was a skin that we got with this bundle, and she came with the backbling dolly. And she also has an edit style to put on this huge doll head on her head, which is terrifying. I almost never run the doll edit style. Not saying it's a bad one, but I just don't like it. I think it's a little bit too bulky for me, but also it's just really creepy and I really just don't like looking at it. And her hands are kind of on fire, which is weird because she's not really on fire at all. And also the backbling is very creepy again. I actually was kind of confused. I thought they were going to put this backbling on a different skin and not be like the exact same thing, but it matches her perfectly. I don't even know why I kind of thought that way. I just thought maybe they would put that on a different character to kind of reflect it off of someone else. Still a great goth girl, though, I must say. And then next skin we had here in this pack was the Katrina skin, which came with the backbling Morning Glory. Not the biggest fan of the backbling, but the skin didn't really need it. If you don't have a backbling on the skin, it actually feels like she already has a backbling. It's kind of similar to how they did it with Battlehound, how he didn't actually have a backbling in the very beginning of his release, and he had just like this cape draped over him, which looked really cool, and now they kind of ruined the backbling where it looks like it's just magnets on him. The point I'm trying to get at is that it almost felt like the backbling was almost an overthought. Like, you didn't even need the back bling. It looks great without one, and the skin itself is very, very unique. I don't see many people running this skin, and it's kind of a shame because I think this one is very well done. It's very intimidating, very creepy, very good for the Halloween season for sure, and it was really good for the addition of the pack. And then the last skin we had here was Black Light, which came with the back bling Indigo Wing. And I'm not a fan of this one. This one was the weakest one out of the three, in my opinion. It was the least intimidating. And it also came with a glow edit style that was barely noticeable. I even put it in my top 10 worst edit styles on skins video. It was very pointless, but the skin itself isn't the worst thing ever. It felt like, yeah, we're gonna shoehorn this in a pack because we don't think people will buy this separate kind of sort of thing, at least with me, with my how I like to think about how they do different things in Fortnite with their skins. It felt like it was just there and they just like, all right, put it in the pack, don't sell it separate. Because if you don't know, Chaos Agent is also part of the same set as these three, as well as skins like Teef and Jawbreaker. There was no way they were going to put those in a pack. They knew they would sell well by themselves. I don't know how they even really decide that. But yeah, the pack itself was very well done. Every pack, in my opinion, is always worth getting. And yeah. Next skin we have here is the Delirium skin, which comes with the backbling Illusion Rune. I think the skin itself is very undervalued. It's so unique in the sense that it just looks like a goat wizard sort of thing. The back bling is what everyone talks about with this guy. The illusion rune is so well done. Again, you can pretty much just throw this on everything. It looks so good, so creepy, so bright, so unique looking. Very good, very well done with that back bling. But the skin itself, I feel like needs more love. It's very cool. And I wish people gave this one more of a chance, but I don't see this coming back very often. I wanted to double check for myself, and yes, it hasn't been out since November 4th of 2019. It's probably going to be a Halloween exclusive skin, which isn't really a big deal, but you probably won't be seeing it anytime in the near future. Next skins we have to talk about here is the Deadball set. We had 8 zombie soccer skins. We had the Sinister Striker. We had the Midfield Monstrosity, the Burial Threat, and the Soul Sweeper for the males. And then for the females, we have the Decaying Dribbler, the Putrid Playmaker, the Fatal Finisher, and the Crypt Crosser. Now, the way they sold these skins was actually pretty interesting. So the male skins all had the same back bling, which was Zomball. But what they did was they made it so you had to get the back bling with the skin. So what you did was you bought one of the soccer skins and you kept the back bling. But then when you went to buy another soccer skin, you were unable to get the back bling again because you already owned it. And the price went down from 1200 to 800, even though technically they are rarity. So that was pretty interesting. And then female skins got the back bling dead card, same thing. You bought one of the female soccer skins, you always got the back bling. You could not buy the back bling separately. And then all the female soccer skins after that were 800 V-Bucks. Overall, I thought they were done pretty well. Kind of upsetting, you couldn't really change the outfit color. You could only change the number, but still, I mean, should we really be upset about that with an 800 V-Bucks skin set, which is actually 1200 in the beginning? It's very complicated to talk about with this. But overall, I think they did them very well. Barely ever use them though, I'm not gonna lie. I thought they were very hype in the beginning because who doesn't like soccer skins at this point? And it was really an interesting thing for them to try to do with this. And it seems like every holiday, they typically try to put out a mass amount of skins related to the same thing regarding the holiday. So I think that's actually a really cool idea. And overall, I think these skins were actually a pretty decent success. I still see the normal soccer skins more than these though. Next skin we have here is the Big Mouth skin, and it comes with the back bling Council of Frogs. Now the Council of Frogs back bling, not a fan at all, never run it. I don't think I've ever run it actually. Like I genuinely don't think I've ever run it. But Big Mouth itself is actually an extremely creative skin. Again, they knocked it out of the park with some of these Halloween skins, I'm telling you. The Big Mouth was no exception. It was a great skin. I love how the concept of the head just being a mouth is very scary to some people. I love how vibrant like the beakers are. I love the creativity that went into this outfit. They did a fantastic job with this one. ADS was a little weird, but I still think the skin was a very well done Halloween skin, and I have not much else to say about it. Next skin we have here is the Haze skin, which comes with a backbling Ridgeback, and it also comes with another edit style, and this skin was awesome. I love this skin. Goth Girls, again, you know it. I love Goth Girls, and this one fits the bill perfectly. Both edit styles are actually fantastic. I don't even know which one I like more, to be honest with you. The light pink hair one with the black clothing, or the black haired one with the dark red clothing and the horns on her head. I don't really know which one I liked more, but they were both really well done. Love these skins a lot. Probably top 10 females in my opinion, maybe. And the back bling wasn't great. Not a fan of the wings anymore. I think they've kind of been overdone at this point, and I just never really like these in particular. I don't really know why, but I still think the skin itself was fantastic. Next skin we have here is Peely Bone, and he does not come with a back bling, but he does come with his own emo, which I think is very hilarious. Now, I have a few issues with this skin, as well as the community in general didn't like. Number one, it is a battle pass skin made into an item shop skin. A lot of people don't really like when that happens. Me personally, I don't really care. It's more on the line of just like really upcharging the price on this one. This was $15. Yes, it comes with its own unique animation emo, which I think actually makes it almost worth the 1500 V-Bucks. But the problem with this is that if you already own Peely, then what is the point in buying this? It almost felt like, I don't even know. Like, I would never recommend buying the skin if you already own Peely. Now, of course, I did. I collect skins in general. This is one of the biggest flex skins, I think, in my personal opinion, is to own the Peely Bone. I don't know many people that do own it. I barely ever see it. And it's just one of those skins where it's like, it's almost summer drift territory. But at least with this one, it does come with a very unique animation that probably took some time to do. So I don't think the skin should have been, oh, it should have been a lot lower price. $15 for this felt a little expensive to me. I still think the outfit was decent, but it's like, I barely even run this one, so I don't know really how I feel about it. I don't think it was executed as well as it could have, but I still think the skin is somewhat decent. Next skin we have here is the Hemlock skin, which came with the back bling Bag of Shadows, and she also comes with an edit style, and she comes with her own emote. Now, this one is one of the best Halloween skins in the game. Reason being is that because her emote allows her to actually change her form in game, which has never been done before. The fact that you could just change your edit style with an emote is so creative, and I thought they did such a good job with this skin in general. The edit style is great, all the black looks really cool, her face is horrifying, but in general I think the skin was done very well. Again, the creativity with these skins, including just like with the emotes, was so good that I really have nothing else to say about it. Next skin we have here is the Grim Fable skin. She also has an edit style, and she comes with the back bling Pack Leader. I'm not the biggest fan of the back bling. Honestly, for whatever reason, I just never wear it. I don't know why I don't like it, but the skin itself is without a doubt top 10 best female skins in the game, period, to me at least. I think this skin was done very, very well. I love how aggressive it is with the wolf on her head. It just makes it look so intimidating. And guess what? Even with the wolf head off of her, she still looks terrifying. I love the aggressiveness of this outfit. If there's one thing I love in Fortnite, it's aggressive outfits and masks. And this one just does it for me so well with the aggressiveness. Without a doubt, this is one of the best skins in the game. I really do like this one. And I hope you guys feel the same, because I think that this one was done very well. It does remind me a lot of Fable, as I'm pretty sure that's what they were going for. They were trying to make like a more souped up Fable, but I think they really nailed it with this one. It was really good, and I'm so happy to have this one. Next skin we have here is Bush Ranger, which comes with the back bling Buzzy Bag. Bush Ranger's adorable. I think the artist community really likes this one, and for good reason. It's extremely creative. It's a tree with pine cones as grenades, like on the strap. Like it's too good. I really do like the skin a lot. The back bling, don't really use it very often. We did use it for our Lackland World qualifier when we actually got into the finals. We did use the Buzzy Bag with the Bigfoot skin, and we ended up winning that, which was really cool that we actually got into the qualifiers. But in general, I think the skin itself is very creative, and I just think the skin is so good. Like, I really have nothing much else to say about it. It's so cute, and I really do think that it should be one of like the next popular skins, kind of like how Fish Stick is. I think this skin will develop a really nice following for it. Now we got to talk about the Dark Fire bundle, which came out on November 5th of 2019, and I know that because that is remember the 5th of November. Dark Power Cord with a dark six string, very shocking. I had no idea that Power Cord of all skins would be getting some sort of like different version to her. I'm very impressed with what they did with this. The dark six string is very cool, and I think the skin itself is amazing. They made her even more pale, which is really funny because I like more pale looking skins anyway. So I think they did a really good job with this one. Looks very creepy, and I just love it. I think it's a very well made skin, and I'm very happy that we have it in the game. Then we had the Molten Omen with the back bling Molten Battle Shroud. I can't say I use this one a whole lot. I like the cape a little bit. The cape only reminds me so much of when we had the original Omen cape back in Season 4, and how revolutionary it was for us to have a cape back bling. We never had it back then, so it was really cool for the time, but now we just kind of have too many capes at this point, and I really just not really seeing myself use it. The Molten Omen, though, is very aggressive looking. I do like the way it looks, and I think it's a very good addition to this pack. Then lastly we had was the Shadow Arc skin, which came with the back bling Shadow Arc Wings. Again, I'm tired of the wings as well, and the Shadow Arc itself is very well in design. I love the texture and the design that they have all over the clothing on this one. Looks very good, but I would never run those wings. I hate how big they are, and I'm really not a big fan of just those kind of wings in general. My favorite wings are the Love Wing ones. Those ones are really well done, and I like those. I like how simple they are compared to like those kinds of wings. Next skin we'll talk about here is the Dark Triceratops, and she comes with a back bling Dark Hatchling. Now, this skin was earnable if you got a certain amount of points, which I believe was 20 points, in a Japan Nintendo Switch contest. First off, you're playing on Asia servers, which is probably not your preferred server. And secondly, you're playing on the Switch and you're trying to get 20 points. Now, 20 points is actually not that difficult, and that's why they haven't really done this for these tournaments in the future with just saying, oh, you need 20 points. Now it's like top 10%, top 15%, top 5% to get these things. They made it a lot more difficult to obtain now, but back then the Dark Triceratops was very easy to get with just 20 points. You could easily camp out like 5 games and get top 25 and then get it. It was very, very simple to get. So it was a little bit special for that time. You were able to flex it for a little bit, and I think the skin itself is very well done. We might as well talk about the Dark Rex as well, which came with the back bling, the Dark Scaly. Again, looks very good. These are 1200 each, by the way, and it's so funny to see how far we've come with legendary skins, how Rex and Triceratops were both $20 and now these are only $12. And they have more life to them than I think the Rex and Triceratops with these kinds of skins in general. So it's really cool to see kind of the evolution of Fortnite skins here. But yeah, I think they were done very well. Next skin we have here is the Brot skin. And he doesn't come with a back bling. He does come with an edit style. And he does come with the Loose Links Contrail. This was encrypted. We had no idea that the skin was even going to be coming out, and I think it's hilarious. I love the way the skin looks. It's just a hot dog with some skinny jeans on. Really comedic. I honestly really like this skin a lot. I like Fortnite's sense of humor with these sorts of skins. They don't take them that seriously sometimes, and I think these skins are really funny. And the Brot is no different. I think this game was very well done, and I do like the skin a lot. I wish I did run it more often. Next skin is the Deadeye skin, which comes with the backbling Second Sight. Now, the Second Sight backbling isn't that crazy. Not the biggest fan of it, but it does look good on some certain outfits, and Deadeye in of itself is actually a pretty cool outfit. He does have an edit style where you can take the hat off. I think the skin is fantastic. It is definitely worth the legendary price, and yes, this is a legendary skin. We haven't had many legendary skins this season, and I don't necessarily know why. I think they're just kind of lowering the price on a lot of skins, which is a really good thing for them to do. It's very consumer friendly. But yeah, this skin definitely feels like it's a legendary. I love the jacket, love the smoke coming off of it. Really well executed. Not much else to say about it. Plus, the fingers are very creepy with those nails. Ugh. But yeah, the skin itself is great. Next skin we have here is Wrath. Like I said, this isn't going to be in any particular order, but I forgot to mention Wrath for the Halloween skins because it was a bundle. And it did come with a backbling called Timekeeper. And the skin itself, I think, is very cool. It has a bunch of edit styles, but the only issue with it is that you can barely see these edit styles. The only way you're able to see it is if you're jumping and you happen to catch the jacket flip backwards so you could see the color. So that's kind of sucky, but besides that, the backbling has really good edit styles that you can clearly see, which is really cool. I think the skin itself was very well done. It also came with some harvesting tools as well, which look pretty cool. He's literally a mummy in like this Western jacket and hat sort of combo. So it's really creative. I really like what they did here, but it doesn't compare to Deadeye. Deadeye just looks so much more cooler than him. He's like the cooler Daniel, and I think that's why I kind of like, oh wait a minute, I forgot about the Wrath skins because I saw the Deadeye. I'm like, oh wait, we had that one too. So yeah, I still think the skin's good, but nothing close to Deadeye. Deadeye just blew it out of the water. Next skin we have here is the Imperial Stormtrooper skin. Does not come with a back bling, and it was 1500 V-Bucks. This was revolutionary. Star Wars and Fortnite was really cool, and this was just wave one of three different waves we would be getting of Star Wars cosmetics, and this is the only one we got. We just got this skin for the first wave around. Was really awesome to see this, and also you actually got the skin for free if you ended up buying Star Wars Jedi Fallen Order on the Epic Game Store, which is really cool. They did this with the Psycho Bandit bundle, which is still going on, by the way. If you buy Borderlands 3 on the Epic Game Store, you do get the Psycho Bandit bundle for free, which is pretty cool that you could still do that now. But yeah, the skin itself was really cool. I mean, it's a Stormtrooper. I mean, what else can you say about it? No back bling. $15 for it felt a little bit steep, but honestly, it's Star Wars. It makes sense for them to actually just make a skin that price. They typically do that with all these kinds of crossover skins, and you'll see what we mean as we go on. Next skin we have here is the Trench Raider skin, and he comes with a backbling torpedo tank. Again, I'm tired of these backblings. I'm not really the biggest fan of this one. Trench Raider to me is a skin that no one remembers. It looks like Shark Boy from Shark Boy and Lava Girl. I love like the harpoons he has, and I like the knife on the right of his boot. I think the outfit itself is very cool. The hair itself is very, very reminiscent of like a shark. It looks really cool. I don't know why people don't like this one. I think it's maybe the character model people don't like. I don't know. But I think the skin itself is really nice, and I'm glad to have owned it. And the next skin we have here is Surf Rider, which is in the same set as this one, and it comes with a backbling short wave. Again, I'm just not feeling the backbling with this one, but Surf Rider is a skin that's also very interesting to me, at least. The preview picture, as you can clearly see, shows her as like a very pale diver, but with the season and how they kind of change the skins, she is incredibly tan looking, and it kind of looks a little strange for her to have like this really tan look. Like, I'm looking at it right now, it's kind of terrifying how tan she is compared to the preview picture of her. But besides that, I still think the skin's very good. I think a lot of people like this skin because the character model is very popular, and the outfit itself is very slim. I don't really see much of the reason as to why you probably wouldn't like this skin. I think the skin is very well done, And yeah, that is what I have to say about that one. Next skin we have here is Big Chuggis, which comes with the back bling Juggis, and I think the skin itself is very unique. Again, we're getting these bigger skins now. They're experimenting with these very bulky Kyle-looking skins from, like, Save the World. They're really experimenting with this sort of thing. They really started it with, like, the Scientist skin and Ripley, and now they did another one with the Big Chuggis skin, which is an obvious reference to the Big Chuggis meme that was kind of present. I don't even think it was present at that time. I think it's another dead meme at this point, especially when that skin came out. I don't think anyone was even talking about Big Chuggis anymore, so a little late on the meme. This skin looks like Bane from Batman. Like, it looks really good. Like, I love the design they have on it. He's, like, made out of, like, the slurp barrels. It just looks so good. Like, I don't know. I don't run it because it's too bulky for me. And for the back bling, I think it's pretty decent. It has like slurp kind of flowing in through this tank, and it kind of looks like it would be fused with slurp, which is really funny. Matches the skin theme perfectly, and I think the skin itself is also very creative, but I don't think I would really wear it too much because of the bulkiness. Next skin we have here is Triggerfish, which comes with two other edit styles, and it comes with the back bling Coral Commandos. Now, I think the skin itself is very well done in the sense that they're trying to replicate like a soldier feel. They've done this with skins like Sledgehammer, but this one really feels very military. And I have to say, I really like the military feel with these skins. The fact that this skin, the fish stick model, was used for something as serious as this is kind of weird. I don't know if I would have much rather something else, but I think this is really funny. It takes itself very seriously, but I think it deserves the seriousness here. I think they did really well with the fish stick because it doesn't look like the normal derpy fish stick. It actually looks like a more aggressive version, almost sort of like an alter ego of fish stick, just saying. And the back bling itself, I think, is very unique. It actually sings and glows when you get a kill. I just don't think it matches his theme too much. Like, I know what they were trying to go for. Like, you can see they have some bandanas on, but I feel like you could just slap this on the regular fish stick and it wouldn't feel out of place at all. So yeah, I feel like Triggerfish is very serious, but I think it's still done very, very well. Next skin we have here is the Skalaxis skin, and it comes with the back bling Spinal Blade. Skalaxis is a very interesting skin. I feel like this was another skin that no one really cared about. It looks really cool. The texture of like the snake and everything with the bones all on them, I think, looks very, very well done. The Spinal Blade is very hard to match, I won't lie. It looks awesome, but I don't really see many skins that actually go with it too well. But the skin itself looks like the cloak star, as if like he turned into a snake, which is really creative. I like how they did that. Very unique skin. I don't see many people run it, and it's kind of a shame because I do think the skin is actually very well put together, and I do hope more people give it a chance when it does eventually come back. Speaking of skins to give more of a chance, we have the Riley skin, which comes with the back bling Ghostly. Now, it's no secret that I really do not like this skin. I've said before, I think this is one of the worst skins in the game due to the fact that it's so lazily made, but I really thought about it. If this skin came out before Shade and before Waypoint, I would actually really like it. I think the skin itself actually isn't terrible. The colors are kind of whatever to me. The logos are kind of eh. The back bling itself is kind of eh because it's just another backpack, but I think the skin itself is not the worst thing I've ever seen. And the fact that the community voted for it over two rather unique looking skins in the form of Turns and Stingray really kind of soured me, because I'm like, I really wanted those skins to win just because, I mean, they're just more creative. And the fact that this one won really soured me on the skin. And maybe that's why I had so much spite for this skin, the fact that the community voted for it and it was just so lazily made. But I honestly have nothing against the artist that made this skin. I have nothing against anyone that likes the skin at all. So I hope that I can start to warm up to the skin a little bit more. But at the moment, I'm still not a fan of this skin whatsoever. Next skin we have here is the Autumn Queen, which comes with the back bling Autumn's Mantle, and they had like this huge Autumn's Queen quest where everyone got a free wrap if they played a certain amount of matches, which I think was really cool of Fortnite to actually kind of do that. And the skin itself is very unique. I love the way this skin looks, and I feel like Fortnite was really hoping that Turns was going to win that vote because it is part of the same set as the Autumn Queen. It would have made a lot more sense to kind of release him alongside with this. It reminds me a lot of Anna from Frozen, just really gives that vibe off, and Elsa does look like Glimmer, so I guess that kind of makes sense. I think the skin is just super creative. I love the back bling too. I think it's very cool. It doesn't really go with too many outfits, I'm not gonna lie, but I can't get over how much I love the simplicity of this skin. and just how unique it is with all the colors, like the fall colors, the brown, the gold trim, the crown. Like, it just looks so good. I love this one. Next skin we have here is the Dominion skin, and it comes with a backbling flame sigil, and I think the flame sigil is sick. I mean, again, this looks like the illusion rune, but it's a lot more universal because it's not pink. Dominion himself looks very aggressive. Love the pants, love the shotgun shells he's got going on. The horns look very good on him as well. The chains around his like wrist, very well done. Very well done outfit, honestly. I love this one. It's an epic, not a legendary. And honestly, I could have seen them bump this one up to a legendary. I think it's that good. Next skin we have here is the Globe Shaker skin, which comes with a backbling ornament. Now we're getting into the Christmas stuff. It almost feels like the skin was going to come out in 2018 with how sweater kind of reminds me of just like Nog Ops and Yuletide Ranger. And the pants is like, we've seen the pants a lot of times before, but I love how Christmassy this skin feels. It was a really well done skin. The backbling is super universal. Throw it on anything, it would totally match. And I love how like the green is. It almost feels like a reflex color green, and you never see that anymore. So I think that was very well done on Fortnite's part. I really do like this skin a lot. Next skin we have here is the Bundle skin, which comes with the backbling Gwynnie, and Gwynnie is amazing. I love this backbling. Again, it's pretty universal. If you really don't care about the scarf color really blending in with all the other skins you have, I think this backbling will just pretty much go with anything. And Bundles itself, I think, is very adorable. Again, it's another Cuddle Team Leader, but it's a rare rarity, which again, they weren't really known for rare rarities. They were really meant for legendary, and then the one Halloween one was an epic rarity. I think the skin itself is adorable. The backbling, I think, might be actually better, though. And that's not really saying that the skin is bad. I don't really think it is. But I do think the backbling is just much better. But the skin itself, I still think, is very good. I love the white. I love the little wiggles that it has going on with the ears. I'm pretty sure every time you shoot, it animates a little bit, which is pretty unique. But that's really all I got to say about Bundles. I think it's a decent skin with a great backbling. Next skin we have here is the Hush skin, which comes with a backbling black stripe. Not a fan of the backbling. Not a fan of it. I really don't like this one at all. But Hush is one of my personal mains I feel like I run. This is a great skin. I love how aggressive it looks. I love the mask. I love how it looks goth. The one unique thing about this skin, though, I must say, is the satchels around her waist. The fact that she has like these kind of bulky satchels around like her upper leg actually kind of adds some character to the skin. You never see it. I love it. I think it's one of my personal favorite skins now. And that's all I have to say about it, really. And then we got the Star Wars stuff for Wave 2. We got the Finn skin with the backbling, the Resistance. Not a fan of the backbling, and honestly, I don't think I've ever run Finn. I'm gonna be honest, I don't think I've ever run this skin before. I love that they're incorporating Star Wars stuff, though. I think it's really unique that they're doing that. So I think he was totally worth the 1500 V-Buck price. Then we had the Rey skin with the backbling, the Jedi Order, which I like the backbling a little bit more than the other one, but the skin itself I also like a little bit more as well. It's very plain, meaning you could pretty much put whatever you want on it. I just thought the whole thing with Star Wars coming to Fortnite was such a cool thing, and I'm really happy that we just have this in the game. And then lastly we had was the Sith Trooper skin, which came with the backbling Sith Trooper Blaster, and this was easily the best one of the three. The backbling is so cool. It goes on anything. It makes your skin look immediately aggressive, having a shotgun on your back. Really cool stuff there. The red and black color scheme, we've seen it before, so it makes sense. People would probably like this, and I think it's really good. I definitely use the backbling a lot more, though. And that was the second wave of Star Wars cosmetics, and I think they did it very well. Next skin we have here is the Yule Trooper skin, and this came with the backbling Sinister Stocking. Again, this was an encrypted skin. We had no idea we were going to be getting this, and I think they did this very well. Reminds me a lot of Nightmare Before Christmas Jack Skellington with the beard and the crazy hat. Yes, it is a Skull Trooper recolor. Were we expecting an edit style? I think they put too much effort into the skin for me to really think it could have been an edit style. I may have said before it could have been an edit style, but that was honestly just like first impressions. I really think about it now and I'm like, it's unique enough. It's a Skull Trooper skin. Of course people are going to like it. Of course people are going to buy it because they know how popular Skull Trooper is. It's a very smart thing for Fortnite to do, in my opinion. But I think the skin is great. I love it, and I think it's a really good Christmas skin, and I'll probably run it a little bit off season as well. Next skin we have here is the Bash skin with the backbling Llama Corn Shield, and I think it's great. It does have a bunch of edit styles for like a military-esque feel to it, and it's very good, very dirty, very grimy, but I think it's very well executed, and I'm very happy that we have it now. Very aggressive too for something that looks like it's from the Bright Bomber set, even though it actually isn't. It's actually from the Leftover set, which has all those crazy skins that kind of looked like a deformed version of what their usual counterparts were, like the Hot House skin, the Gut Bomb skin. It's like that, except it's a lot more grimier and a lot more aggressive looking, and I think they did a really good job with the Bash skin here. It's probably my favorite one of all of those, and the Llama Corn shield looks so good on a lot of different outfits. It's so colorful, so you could pretty much, again, slap this on anything, and it wouldn't really do too bad in terms of combo potential. Next skin we have here is now the third wave of Star Wars stuff. We have the Zori Bliss skin, which actually did not come with a back bling. This is gonna be one of those flex item shop skins. If you actually own this skin, I would actually be kind of shocked because it didn't come with a back bling. I don't know many people that actually know what this character even is from Star Wars. I mean, I don't really follow Star Wars and I didn't even know what this was. I know who Kylo Ren is, which will be the next one we talk about, but quickly before I get to that one, I think the skin itself is decent. The head is extremely aggressive. It kind of looks like a battery. And the fact that it's so jutted from the back looks really aggressive. And I'm really happy to actually have this skin. I don't see anyone running it. I think I've seen maybe one person run it in a fashion show of all things. So yeah, I just don't see it run very often. And then we have the Kylo Ren skin, which came with the back bling Kylo's cape, which is super cool. Kylo Ren is super aggressive looking. I love the outfit. I love the way he looks. I like the hood down as well, by the way. When you, with the cape, you have an edit style where you can like put the hood down. I think it's really cool. I think the hood up is cooler though, in my opinion. I love the way the cape looks. Was really good, really well executed, and I'm so happy we actually got Kylo Ren in Fortnite. Next skin we have here is the Frosted Flurry skin, which did not come with a back bling, but she does have a bow in her butt, and there's actually a reason why she has a bow in her butt, is that that's kind of like her back bling. If you put a back bling on the skin, the bow actually goes away, which makes sense because it would probably clip through a lot of the back blings. They should kind of do that already with like the tails. Like if it clips through the back bling, just don't include the tail. But I really like the bow on there. I think it's really cute, but I do think that I like running back blings too much, so I almost never get to see the bow, which isn't like the biggest deal. Oh my god, I can't see the Frosted Flurry bow because I'm wearing a back bling. Like, really, first world problems here. So I really don't think it's that big of a deal. I think it's really unique that they actually do that. And honestly, I could kind of see them doing that more often with certain things. But next skin we have here is the Kane skin, and it comes with the back bling Sweet Spikes. No, it's not Kane from the WWE, as I made that joke already. But yeah, Kane is really skinny and really aggressive. This is perfect for any competitive player that just wants a really skinny character. And it also kind of reminds me of an Outlander from Save the World with the hands, I think. Because if you don't know, their hands kind of have like roboticness to them. And I think it's really well executed. The back bling's okay. I don't think there's enough going on with the skin for me to say it's an epic, though. Like, am I wrong for thinking that? Like, this could have been a rare, in my opinion. But that's just me. I don't think they're like, oh, they're being stingy. I just think there isn't enough going on with it. Next skin we have here is the Trilogy skin, which you got as a PlayStation Celebratory Pack. I think this skin is very well done. It also comes with the backbling Reliant Blue, but I really don't want to talk about it. It's not that great. I think the skin itself is really nice. It's a female version of the Carbon Commando skin. It's a very solid outfit, in my opinion. Very compact, and I do like running it from time to time. Next we have to talk about is the Frozen Legends bundle, which we're going to talk about for a decent amount here. We're going to talk about the Frozen Fish Stick, the Frozen Nogops, the Devourer, and also Codename Elf, even though he technically came out in Season 2. But we're going to get in order here with the Frozen Fish Stick. Can't say I've run this one at all. It's an obvious choice for them to include a Frozen Fish Stick in a pack. Obviously, Fish Stick is a very popular skin. It makes total sense for them to actually do that, but I can't say I've actually run it actually at all. The Frozen Nogops is also kind of not really a surprise. Nogops is a very popular skin in the community. The hat is actually different, which I gotta commend them for. It's not just a blatant reskin. It's actually really nice, and I really like the way that this skin is. I actually might like it more than the normal Nogops. And the Devourer is a meme. I mean, it has an edit style where it's just no ice, and it looks terrifying without that ice. It also comes with a backbling called Castle Peaks, which is really nothing super crazy. I think it's a very interesting pack. It's not like the best pack I've ever seen. It's probably more on the lower end, but the reason why it's so popular, probably besides the Nogops, is the Codename Elf skin. And it did have a minty edit style that was released sometime near that time, and it never came back in the item shop. And if you wanted this skin from Season 2 and you were anticipating for it, you were forced to pay $25 to get this skin. Now, yes, you did get the Devourer, you got the Frozen Fish Stick, and you got the Frozen Nogops. But something about this felt very fishy to me. The fact that they're selling an item shop skin in a bundle now, me personally, I think it was just due to the fact that they were so desperate for sales on this thing. They knew no one barely bought it back in season two, at least I think no one really bought it, and no one was really excited for it, right? Like, I don't think many people were anticipating Codename Elf's return just because it just didn't really look like a good skin. I don't know, I feel kind of bad saying that, but I feel like it's kind of true in a sense. I don't think many people really liked Codename Elf that much, and to see them put it in a pack because they were just desperate for sales, maybe, I don't necessarily know how I feel about it. I think the best thing they could have done, include it in the pack, sure, but sell it separately in the item shop. Like, right now, if you go to any website that kind of tells you when things were last seen in the item shop, it still actually tells you that it hasn't come back, because it hasn't come back into the item shop. And I said this on Twitter, it's a really random and stupid thing, but technically, if you own the Codename Elf, but you did not buy the Frozen Legends bundle, you still technically have a rare version of Codename Elf. There's no way to really prove it unless you show your locker to someone, but it is something to note. If you have Codename Elf, but you did not buy the pack, you still technically have a rare version of Codename Elf, but no one would really know about it, so it's kind of a pointless flex there. But yeah, I think the skin itself should have been just sold separate and just sold in the item shop as well. I think it's just kind of lame that they did that, and I've never really heard of a game putting something that was in an item shop system and then make it into a pack and never release it again. I think that was kind of dumb that they did that, but that's just my opinion. I also think I should just mention this here. The Minty edit itself for Codename Elf was really well done. I really do enjoy it. And also the Elf Shield, which he did get a back bling finally because it was a rare skin. And that back bling also had a Minty edit style, and I think that was done very well as well. I really don't think I have anything else to say about Codename Elf. It's really a shame that they kind of did what they did with it. And I'm not calling like Fortnite evil for doing what they did. It just felt sleazy to do, to put something that was in the item shop into a pack like that. Not really a good idea, in my opinion, to do that, especially like if you were one of the people that were waiting for Codename Elf and you saved $12 for 2 years to get this skin just for the fact that you had to pay $25 for it, felt kind of like a slap to the face. But I guess Fortnite could be doing a lot worse things. I mean, you never know what they could be doing to make the item shop a lot worse, right? Like, they've spoken out before about like how they don't like loot boxes in video games, and I kind of have to commend Fortnite for just being so consumer friendly. It's just like with this instance where I almost felt like this was a really bad idea for Fortnite to do, but that's just my opinion. I don't think it's that big of a deal if you really think about it. It's just a little thing that I've noticed. Next skin we have here is the Dolph skin, which comes with the Backbling Bow Breaker. Dolph is great. Dolph is probably one of the best Christmas skins we got this season. It might actually be one of the best Christmas skins of all time right now. I just love the design of it. I love how cartoony he looks. The price was really good on it. The back bling was really nice as well. I really don't have much else to say about it. It's just a really solid skin. And he's got three fingers. He's like an actual reindeer. It's not just a mask. It's kind of weird. And he's got a sock in his horn. He's got glasses on that have trees on him. It's just such a crazy outfit, but it's really well done and I'm really happy to have it. Next skins we have here is the Holly Jammer, the Cozy Commander, the Jolly Jammer, and the PJ Patroller. They all have their own edit styles, and these were just some Christmas skins that they just threw together for us, and I think that they're really worth it. 800 V-Bucks for each was really cool. I guess like my only small first world problem complaint is the fact that one of them is called Jolly Jammer and the other one is called Holly Jammer. Like, you couldn't find a word to put with like in front of an H with Holly Jammer instead of just using the word jammer twice. I don't know, little nitpick there, really doesn't even matter with these skins at all. It's just something I noticed, but I think the skins are actually pretty decent. I like that they kind of make multiple of these sort of skins where they just kind of include multiple versions of a skin so you could just pick one character model you like and then just be done with it. I think that's really cool that they did that. And it also actually came with the Backbling Yule Breakers, which you actually had to buy separate. What they did with like the zombie soccer skins, you were forced to buy the Backbling with the skin, and then after you own the Backbling, you could just buy the skin. In this case, they just sold the Backbling separate, so I don't know why they kind of like switched their ideas with that. But regardless, I think the Backbling's all right. I mean, it matches pretty decently with a lot of skins, but the skins themselves I think are very well done, and I'm very happy to have them all. Next skin we're going to talk about here is the Cutie Pie skin. Does not come with the back bling, but it does have an edit style to take the head off. Very creepy. I actually don't even really run this one a whole lot, and I feel kind of bad about that because I think the skin itself is actually really good. It's like a remixed version of Mayhem. I think the skin is very well done. It's very creepy. It's like a better version of Grimble's, and I feel bad to say that because I think Grimble's is a really funny and meme-y skin, but I think this one was just done a lot more better, a lot more aggressive, and the fact that you could take the helmet off was a really nice touch. So honestly, I think the skin is very well done and not much else to say about it. Next skin we have here is the Shiver skin, which came with the back bling ice wings. I was kind of tired of seeing skins that look like demons. Plus, I felt the jacket was almost kind of unoriginal, but actually the outfit isn't even that bad. The gloves are a little bit oversized on her. But not only that, this is actually part of the same set as the Ice King and the Ice Queen. So this is technically, I guess, like their daughter or something, which is very weird to think about that skins have children. I don't even know. But it's part of the same set, and it makes me feel like this is like their teenage daughter or something, which doesn't really mean much. But I think the skin itself is okay. Tired of wings, but I did not like the skin when it first came out. I've warmed up to it now. I think it's actually pretty decent. Next skin we have here is Flatfoot, which comes with the backbling Easy Reach. Now, Flatfoot is pretty interesting. It looks like a female Bruce Willis, and I think it's actually really well executed, and I think it's a good skin. It was encrypted as well, so no one knew this was coming out. I think it was a very well-made skin, and the backbling is good, except it doesn't stick on everyone's back. It only really sticks on this skin's back, which really sucks because the backbling itself is actually really cool and really intimidating and really aggressive, but I don't like running it because it barely even hangs onto the skin. It looks like it should just peel off the back. So kind of a bummer there, but I still think the backbling is really cool on her. And the skin itself, I think, is actually very well done. She has no shoes. That's all I have to say about it. Next skin we have here is the Bow Bros skin. They finally released the Bow Bros, and it came with the backbling Bow Basket. Now, this skin has 4 edit styles. 1500 for this was really well done. I loved this skin. I still do. I think the skin is very creative. Each edit style has their own personality. They each have their own feel to it. The ADS is not great, but guess what? It's better than Beast Modes, and I will hold that up. I will say that this is a lot better than Beast Mode in terms of uniqueness, and especially with the ADS. This one is really good. And I have not much else to really say about it. We've had this in the leaks for, I feel like, over a year before they ended up releasing it. So I'm very grateful that they did release it because it was one of those skins in the community, especially on Twitter, that were like, we really want this skin to come out. Finally did come out. And also the back bling, it steams, which is, I think, is actually really cool. Like, it's just a very nice, simple back bling. Very oriental, but I like that. So it's really good. Next skin we have here is the Polar Patroller. And this came with the back bling Ice Fisher. It's like a riot shield with like some frost on it. Really cool. And I think the skin itself is also very good. Very big. Again, we're talking like big Chuggis levels here of really big. But I think it's also very well done. The snout also gets in the gun when you're like ADS. I'm sorry, I'm putting my hand over my face. But that's what it kind of feels like. When you have the gun aiming down sights, it just kind of like goes in your nose and you can't even breathe. I mean, it's stupid that I even did that. But you get my point, is that it looked kind of weird, but as long as you really don't focus on that, which I don't think many people really do, it's passable. I think it's very good. The ADS actually isn't that bad, but it does kind of make you look like a bigger target with how big the skin is. So it's definitely not going to see any competitive play. At least I don't think it would. But it's a very well done skin. I love it, and I think it's a very good one, and I think people should give this one more of a chance. Next skin we have here is the Astra skin, which comes with a back bling Shining Star, and it also comes with an edit style where it just has some stars moving, but I never really like talking about that because it's really not that interesting. I love the original edit style a lot more. It's not a useless edit style, but it's an edit style that I just don't typically like to use at all. I think the other one is just a lot better. Astra is one of those skins that a lot of people really do like. It's one of those really unique ones. The back bling is super universal. You could put it on anything, it would work. It's kind of like the Galactic Disc to me, at least. You could just literally put it on anything and it would just kind of match itself. I love how messy her hair is. It kind of makes me feel like that. It's just like a really sleepy looking skin, and I really do like it. The gloves are also kind of interesting as well. Like, it's not even the right color, but it matches her belt buckle and also the buckle below her neck there. So I think it's also very well done. Very slim for competitive play. I think it's actually a very good skin, and I think a lot of people do like it anyway. Next skin we have here is the Snow Patroller, and he comes with a back bling Cryo Chamber. Now, I want to talk about this back bling because the reactiveness to this is so kind of dumb, in my opinion at least. It reacts more to where you are. If you're in a very hot environment, it'll get more red to the right. But if you're in a more cold area, when the skin was released, there was snow everywhere, it would go more on the blue. The fact that they released this when there was snow everywhere on the map was really dumb. Even if you went to the beach when it still had like snow everywhere, it would say it was hot. And it's like, I almost kind of wish the skin was released when there was no snow on the ground and was only in that selected area. Minor nitpick, but we were kind of losing our minds trying to figure out what this back bling even did because of all the snow. But the skin itself is one of my top 10 favorite male skins of this season, without a doubt. Love the skin. The mask is really intimidating. I love masks that look like that. I just think the skin itself is just very well done. I'm very happy to own it. It's one of my personal favorites. The skull gloves as well is very, very good, and I will continue to use it in the near future. Next skin we have here is the Arctica skin, and it comes with a Backlink Modern Summit. The pink almost does not match her hair. It matches more on her glasses and her lipstick, actually. But the skin itself, I think, is really cool. The chrome on her body is really unique. I love the beanie. I like beanies a lot. It's a really sassy looking outfit from her feature pose alone. And I think the skin itself is actually really good, and I do use it from time to time, actually. I guess maybe why I don't use it too much right now, or in general, is because we've had too many Fisher looking skins in this season, or like mountain climbers, and I'm just kind of tired of seeing them. Still a good skin regardless, but I just typically don't use it a whole lot because, again, I just feel like we have an overabundance of these like Fisher skins and all these mountain climber skins. Next skin we have here is the Depth Dealer, and it comes with a Backbling Wave Piercer. Again, I'm really kind of tired of just seeing these like backpacks. Like, they all look so similar to one another, so I'm not really a fan of it. Depth Charger is interesting to me. He looks very aggressive. He's actually the male version of the Wavebreaker skin, which we will get to very soon. I think the skin is very well done, though. Not much else to say about it. It's kind of a generic sort of skin, at least to me. I still think the skin looks really nice, though. It's another Fisher skin, so I'm like, still a pretty decent skin nonetheless. Next skin we have here is the Wavebreaker skin, and this comes with the Backbling Dry Bag. And the Dry Bag is, again, another boring Backbling that I really don't run at all. But Wavebreaker, to me, is actually a pretty decent skin. This is actually a part of a starter pack from this season, and I think it's very well done. I really do enjoy the skin a lot. I think it's very, very unique in the sense that it doesn't look like a Fisher kind of person, even though I think that's what they were kind of going for with this one. And plus the harvesting tool that comes with it. I know I'm not talking about harvesting tools in this video, but it's very, very good. Like, a lot of people really like the sound of it. Very well done. Very good outfit, very good starter pack in my opinion. Just, I'm tired of the same back blings that we keep getting here. Next thing we have here is the Bright Blaster, which comes with not a back bling, but comes with a harvesting tool called the Bright Bashers. The skin was also in a vote that definitely did not win. I definitely don't think many people even like this skin at all. It's just not really something that people really like in their Fortnite skins. It's a unique skin. I like it a little bit. I don't really run it too much, but it's actually one of those skins where it's like, I know no one else is really running him, so I'm gonna wear him because I want to feel unique. I've had multiple videos talking about how I like wearing unique skins that no one really likes to run. I don't see no one running this one, and I actually do kind of like it a little bit, but I'll like it more the more I wear it, so I should probably give it more of a chance. But it definitely goes well with six strings, so I mean, why not, right? Next skin we have here is the Rustler skin with the Backbling Leather Lugger. Not a fan of the Backbling at all, but the skin itself is one that a lot of people have been wanting. It was in a vote that actually lost. Shockingly enough, the skin took its time coming out. It was in the trailer. A lot of people saw it. A lot of people really wanted it. And eventually it did come out, and I think the skin is very well done. It's very unique. I love the cowboy feel. I mean, we've had cowboys before, but I think this one was really well done. Yes, she does have short shorts. Yes, you can see her belly button. It's very revealing. It's very skimpy, but I think the outfit itself is still very well done. And I'm not really shocked that people wanted this skin. It's actually really good. Besides all the skimpiness to it, I still think it's very good. Then we have the Wrangler skin, which comes with a Backbling Saddlebag. Again, I don't like it, but this one looks a little bit better than the one that Rustler had. I will say it's same set as well. I do like this one a little bit more. No one really likes this guy. I don't really see why, though. I think it's actually a really cool outfit. Yes, he's another Fisher guy, but I still think it's really cool. I like the glasses. I like the model. Like, I don't think we've ever really seen this model used that much before. It's very formal, and I don't see anyone really singing its high praises or anything. Next skin we have here is Monks, which came with the Backbling Peel Pack, and a lot of people thought this was going to be a Christmas skin because it was in like the Christmas skin leaks. It's very well done. I really do like this one. It's one of the best meme looking skins we have. The ADS actually isn't even that bad, and I think the skin itself is very good. It feels like a sock monkey. Like, the way it looks, you almost feel like you could touch it. I know that sounds kind of weird, but it does feel like a sock monkey. Like, they needed to make it look like a sock monkey, and they did. The fabric looks really good on it, and I really do like it. The back bling is okay. I mean, I don't know what else you would put with a sock monkey. You might as well give it like a banana that has that same fabric. It makes total sense. So I do totally get the back bling. Next skin we have here is Bull Shark, which comes with the Backbling Shark's Tank. Again, I'm tired of these backblings. They look so similar to one another, so I'm not really a fan of it. Bull Shark is a decent skin. I think the skin itself isn't that bad. I love the look of it. The hoodie actually reminds me of the Bape brand, if you guys have ever heard of that. It really looks like that to me, and it looks really well done. I do really like this skin, and I think no one remembers it, and I'll tell you why I think no one really remembers it. Because as soon as this skin came out, the next day, we got Ninja. Yes, the actual streamer personality, Ninja, got put into the game, and he actually came with his own backbling called Ninja's Edge, which is just some katanas, and he came with four edit styles. Fantastic for Fortnite to finally give us a ninja skin in the game. There's so many other content creators that I do definitely think deserve some skins in the game, but I'm happy that Ninja was the first one, because I feel like regardless if you like him or you hate him, you think he's a toxic person, whatever you think of him, I feel like he was in the most of deserving for the first skin. He has kind of paved the way for Fortnite in of itself. I mean, if it wasn't for Ninja, I don't think I would ever really be getting into the game. I remember my first video of Ninja was when he was playing with the new Raven skin, and he had the Love Wings back bling, and he also had the Reaper pickaxe, and I felt like it was so badass of him to wear that combo and him to just wreck Tilted Towers the way he did back then. It was just really cool, and I feel like he brought a lot of eyes to the game. So without Ninja, I feel like a lot of us wouldn't be here right now, and I greatly appreciate Ninja for everything he's done for the community. Again, you don't have to like him, you don't have to love him, but you do have to respect him for the fact that he paved the way for Fortnite in its current state right now. Next skins we have here is the Chill Count skin, the Arctic Intel, the Chill Out, the Hailstorm, the Ice Intercept, the Ice Stalker, the Snow Sniper, and the Snow Striker. Again, we have eight of these skins that are kind of like similar to one another, but they're a little bit different at the same time. Four male, four female. Each male and female have their own kind of design on them, and I think they're actually fairly decent. I don't know why you would buy multiple of these skins, because it just kind of seems pointless to do that, but I've seen a lot of pro players actually use some of the females, and I think they're actually really good. I think these skins are actually really creative. Like, we've never seen skins like this before, and I think they were really well done. They didn't come with the back bling or anything, but I think these skins are actually very good. Next skin we have here is the Jelly, which came with the backbling Shelly. And I almost feel like this backbling wasn't really meant for him. Like, he doesn't even look like he would wear a backbling. But the backbling itself is very unique. It has edit styles and it matches so many different skins. It's very well done. Really do enjoy it. And the Jelly skin in and of itself is another meme skin. Again, it's really funny. The ADS on him, for whatever reason, I really don't like it. I think it just has to do with the fact that it takes up the entire left of your screen, and that really is kind of annoying for me. I still think the skin is hilarious. It's very simplistic in nature, but it's so good. I think it's a really good one, and I'm really happy that we have it in the game. Next skin we have here is the Gan, or the Gon, I don't know how you pronounce it. And he comes with an edit style, and he also comes with a backbling Blue Wave. And the Blue Wave is actually not the worst backbling I've ever seen. It's actually kind of nice and compact, kind of unique in a sense. It has like a fan, has like some sake on the side. I believe that's sake. I could be completely wrong with that. But I think the skin itself is one that no one bought. It's simple. The fact that he's kind of molding on the first edit style with the hair all in the back, and then on the second one he's completely bald with the yellow. Yes, he does look like that one guy from Dragon Ball Z. I believe his name was Krillin, but that didn't really inspire people to want to buy the skin. I kind of can't blame him. It's one of those skins that I feel like is almost like kind of a flex again. If you bought it and if you actually run him, it's kind of surprising because I've never really seen anyone run him at all. But I think the skin is still unique. I mean, yeah, it's definitely unique. It's just people just don't like buying ugly skins sometimes. And I'm saying it is kind of ugly, but I don't think it's the worst skin ever by any stretch. Next skin we have here is the Tigress skin, which comes with the backbling Jade Blades. And I love the color they went with this. It's very emerald feeling. I do like the look of it. The tiger, obviously the tiger stripes is really good. I like the different colors that they have going on here. The outfit is also very unique. It's like a onesie almost that reaches to like the top of her leg. It's actually kind of hard to explain, but it's like really short on her. And the backbling itself I also think is also very cool. Not a lot matches with this skin though. Not a lot matches with the backbling either, but I still think it's a very good one. Next skin we have here is Swift, and it comes with a backbling Rat Lantern. A lot of people like to compare this to Drift, because Swift and Drift, and not only to mention that, but it also just has like that Kitsune mask that the Drift has, and I think this one is very well executed. Red, gold, and black looks very clean on a skin, and again, this just looks super good. I love this skin. The backbling is also very cool as well. Very well done for a skin. I mean, it was Year of the Rat for Pete's sake, so it makes sense for them to make like a rat looking skin, and I feel like they did that with this one. Very well done, Fortnite. You did really good with these skins. Next skin we have here is the Jade Racer. It comes with an edit style, which is blue, which is really nice. Also comes with the backbling Dragon Guard, and it doesn't even say it's reactive. every time you jump with this back bling, it actually sparks a little bit on the bottom ends there, which is really cool and really creative. Why they wouldn't say that was what the back bling did in the description, I don't know. I don't know why they wouldn't say that. It's a really cool feature. I love these skins. Feels like Akira. Love it, love it, love it. I almost kind of wish you could remove the helmet or like maybe pull up the visor. But besides that, I think these skins are fantastic. I love them and I think they're very, very good. And that's what I have to say about it. Next skin we have here is the Smoke Dragon skin, which also comes with a color added style, which is blue and gold. And it also comes with the back bling bladed breath. Really well done with this outfit as well. Very skinny again. Again, almost feels like a Cloak Star kind of feel. And it also kind of feels like Cloak Shadow in a way as well, which is pretty funny. They're both cloaked, but really cool outfit. Very well designed, very skinny, very competitive friendly. I feel like love the color schemes going on here. Again, they blow me away with these very oriental designs. They did a fantastic job with these. Next skin we have here is the Shifu skin. Another skin in the leaks that was in there for a little bit. Comes with the back bling Kunai Shield. Very unique. I love this outfit. I think it's very cool to have like an old man in the game, even though I don't think we've really had older men looking like this in the game. I mean, we have the one Riptide version of Turk. But besides that, I think the skin is very well done. He actually, I think, was supposed to come with an emote, but they never released that. It was called Distracted. And the backbling itself is also very cool. The shield is very big. Like, it's a very, very circular and big shield to put on any skin. It's almost a little too big for me, at least. But the skin itself is very cool. Glad they finally released it, and that's all I have to say about it. I actually thought it was going to be released with Bow Bros. Guess they just wanted to wait a little bit with it. I don't even think they're related, to be honest with you. Next skin we have here is the Stingray skin, which also comes with the backbling Manta. Now, I've heard people make comparisons with Manta to the one backbling from season 3, the green one that's really gross that no one likes. And the skin itself is extremely aggressive. I love the eyes that kind of glow through the chainmail on his head, which is really cool. The ADS is very strange because the head is not the normal kind of head model that we're used to. It looks like a thumb. Like, I don't know how else to explain it. He kind of looks like a thumb from Spy Kids. And he also looks like Thelonious from Shrek, which I've made that joke many times already before, but it's kind of true. Like, it's a very skinny body, but like the head is like a thumb. Very strange design, but I kind of like it actually. It's really aggressive, really cool. And that's all I have to really say about it. Next skin we have here is the Caution skin, which does not come with a back bling, but it does have a hood down edit style. This skin honestly has a lot of detail to it. I'm really surprised they actually gave this one an uncommon. I really like it. It's like a budget Alpine Ace, and I do really like the Alpine Ace and Mogul Master skin, so I definitely like this one. The hair slip back was also kind of interesting as well. Next skin we have here is the Clash skin, which comes with the backbling Contender, but it is sold separate, just to point that out. Now, this is actually in the same set as Caution, which I don't necessarily understand. They don't match at all. I don't get the same vibes from them at all. And also, Clash was in the item shop for super long, while Caution, I think, was only in the shop for like a day or two, which is kind of strange, I guess, because Clash sells more, whatever. It looks like Calamity. A very aggressive and different looking Calamity nonetheless. It's still a very, very clean outfit. I've seen a lot of people start using this skin, and for good reason. I think it's very well made, very slim, very cool. I do enjoy the skin. I don't really run it that much because, again, I don't run skins that a lot of people like to run, but it's still a very great design as well, and I'm understanding as to why it's run as much as it is. And the Contender back bling, it's okay. It actually goes with a lot of different outfits, surprisingly, that are purple, so I can't really flack it for that. Again, I'm kind of tired of the backpacks, though. We see it too much this season. Next skin we have here is the Metal Mouth skin, which comes with 3 added styles, and the Zadie skin, which also comes with 3 added styles. We might as well talk about both of these at the same time. I think these skins are very aggressive and very well made. I think maybe my only issue is with the male skin. You do have a lot of bulk around the neck, but besides that, I think the skin is still very good. It doesn't even make me not like the skin. It's just something I noted, but I think it's still a very good skin. I love these added styles. They look super great. Very intimidating. And Zadie as well, same exact thing. Love the edit styles on these guys. They're super aggressive, and that's all I can ask for in a skin is aggressiveness and masks. That's just something I really like in the game, and they nail it perfectly here. Next skin we have here is the Harley Quinn skin. Does not come with a back bling, doesn't really need one, and it has an edit style, and it's very good. Very, very close to the actual Harley Quinn. It's actually kind of scary how close they actually got to the real Harley Quinn. Very good, very well done. It was sold for like 10 days in a row. I really don't blame them for doing that. It's a very good skin. I love when they do these crossovers because they always do such a fantastic job with the skins. And I feel like more people related with Harley Quinn instead out the Star Wars skins because I think kids like Harley Quinn more than Star Wars. At least to me, I don't really know. But yeah, they did a fantastic job with this, and I just hope they keep going with these amazing collabs. Next skin we have here is the Lovethorn skin. Now we're getting into like the Valentine's Day skins. Comes with an edit style, which is super aggressive looking. They both look really aggressive, but I think the dark purple one looks even more aggressive. And it comes with a backbling infatuation pack, which also has an edit style. Very, very well done. I'm not really the one to run this skin though. Like, you'd think with me that loves pink would really run this one with like six string, but I typically don't run this one a whole lot. It's just one of those skins where it's like, it's good, but will I actually see myself run it? I guess not. I haven't really given this one a fair shake, so I feel like it's kind of not in my place to actually say, oh yeah, this skin's bad, because I don't think it's bad. I just typically don't run it for some reason. I still don't necessarily know why. Next skin we have here is the X skin. Extremely aggressive should be like his tagline, extremely. It's so good. I think this might actually be the reason why I'm not running Lovethorn as much, is because X and the other skin upcoming are so good. I love the jacket. I love the outfit. It's very unique. The full red and the little bit of white is very creepy to me. It's very aggressive. Run Love Wings on this thing and it would look great on him. It's super intimidating. I love how small the eyes are as well. It's just, there's everything about this outfit. I just love it. It's just a very well-made outfit in my opinion. Uncommon as well. Very cheap as well. Next skin we have here is the Crusher skin. And I think this one is also very well done. It's an Evelyn skin. But yeah, so Crusher would be the second Evelyn skin that is an uncommon, and they did a great job with this skin. I think a lot of people like this one, which is good because I like seeing this character model run a lot because it doesn't really get that many skins. It's a very solid outfit that I do see a lot of people running. Next skin we have here is the Pinky skin, and it comes with the backbling Pinky's Pink Pack. A lot of P's there. This skin was created by Fantasy Fool, who you may know as the person that made the Guild and Aura skins. Very well done with this skin as well. I really do like this skin. I know a lot of the community actually doesn't like it, which is fine. People can dislike whatever they dislike. I still personally like this skin a lot though. It is very creepy in nature because of the mask is just so like, it's a little weird. And the fact that the skin is so pale compared to like every other skin that is even in the game right now, it's kind of creepy. But I still think the skin is very well done. I'm very happy that we got another artist skin in the game. It's very cool to see, and yeah. The backbling is okay, I'm not the biggest fan of it. And the final skin that was released into the item shop as I am recording this video is the Candyman skin. This skin has no backbling. It's reactive in the sense that his head turns all the way around to say kiss me every time you eliminate an opponent. I liked the idea of this skin. I thought it was a very good idea, but I felt like it wasn't enough to warrant the epic price. But that's just me. I think the skin is extremely troll. I love the faces it makes, and I think the skin itself is very creepy and just outright bizarre looking. But I think the skin itself is very good, and I do run it actually from time to time. It's actually not the worst skin ever. It does almost feel like a flex skin though, because it's $15 for a skin with no backbling, and it just kind of looks like this. It's a strange one nonetheless, but that was the last new skin to come out during this season. And there's some other skins I didn't even talk about, so I'm going to just talk about them here. I'm sorry these aren't in order like I said, but we didn't talk about the Woolly Warrior. This skin was actually given to those for free just for playing it during the 14 days of Fortnite event, which was very fun, and it had a lot of free rewards. It was really a good time for Fortnite, and the free skin I think is actually really good. Does not come with a backbling or anything, but I think the outfit itself is very unique. I would have paid money for this skin. I feel like a few people would actually do that. We've never seen anything like this before. I mean, Fortnite giving out free skins, they could easily have done like recolors or something, but they actually made a rather unique skin for people. Again, completely free. All you had to do was just play during the time, and all you had to do was just open up some presents, and you got it for free. You didn't have to do anything for it. No challenges and nothing. And then also we had to talk about the Lieutenant Evergreen skin, which came with a built-in emote, as well it came with a backbling called the Regifter. And the Regifter is just nothing really crazy to write home about, but the Lieutenant Evergreen skin is actually really cool. The outfit is actually built like a ghillie suit. And that's really impressive that Fortnite actually kind of incorporates that into the game. And I think it's a very well done skin. I don't really run it. I mean, I don't see many people running it anymore. But it, again, this is a free skin for literally just going on the game and just opening up a bunch of presents. You literally did not have to play the game to get these two skins for free. So kudos to Fortnite for actually doing that. That was very nice of them to do. They literally did not have to do that. Next game we gotta talk about here is the Complex skin, and it came with the backbling Purple Jam. Now what's interesting about the backbling is that no one actually has this. Complex was given to those that got to top 10% in a specific tournament, which a lot of people couldn't get to because it was on a different region that people were used to. And honestly, this skin is awesome. I think the skin is actually a really good one, and I really hope we do see it sometime in the near future, but it hasn't been fully released to everyone just yet. And the backbling was not given to those that actually got the skin, which tells me that basically this skin, yes, will be made available in the item shop. A few people were asking me saying, hey, do you think this skin's actually going to be in the item shop? Yes, I do think it will. You just got to give it a little bit more time. And then also the Tango skin, which also comes with the backbling Hurricane. And Hurricane has not been awarded to those that have played in the PlayStation Cup and actually got the top 5%. If you got the Tango skin, you didn't even get the backbling, which pretty much tells me that the skin will be made available in the item shop. So right now, if you do have it, if you did earn it, you might as well flex it before it comes into the item shop. I also want to talk about the Oro skin. This skin also comes with the backbling Radiant Mantle. And the reason why we're going to talk about this here is because it's in the leaks. And I think this is going to be the last skin that comes out for this season. And the skin is very bright gold, very nice and elegant looking here. And I firmly believe that this is going to be the last skin we see. People were saying this might be a battle pass skin. I could see it, but at the same time, I think this is actually just going to be an item shop skin. It's also legendary, which again, there hasn't been many legendary skins whatsoever this season, so it would be really cool to see this come out in the item shop sometime in the near future. I'm predicting in like a day or two we will be seeing it. And then there's some other skins in the leaks that I've already talked about before, but I'm only going to talk about two more. We're going to talk about the Turn skin. This skin comes with the backbling Hollow Horn. This was a part of another community vote and it did not win. It's a very unique outfit. I really like this one, and I really hope we do see it come out next season. And then finally, the last one I want to talk about is the Wake Rider. And the backbling is called Wave Fuel. Not a fan of the backbling. Again, it's another backpack, but this was also in another community vote that did not win. And I do think we will be seeing this sometime in the near future, but that'll be it, guys. That is every single skin and backbling that has come out during Chapter 2 Season 1, as well as some other ones that I wanted to mention, but that is it. So hopefully you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, let me know the like, but only if you enjoyed the content. Subscribe to the channel if you're brand new, and turn on that bell just so you get all my latest uploads. And comment down below, what did you think about the cosmetics we got this season? Because honestly, besides some of the backblings looking a little bit too similar and too backpacky, I thought the cosmetics this season were fantastic. Follow me on Twitter at ITalkFortnite. Follow me on Instagram, ICanTalkFortnite. And if you'd like to use me for support a creator, my code is ITalkFortnite. So thank you all so much that use that code. Seriously, you really do help me out a lot. And thank you guys so much for watching. I'll catch you all later. See ya.